It is, of course, the winner of the Best British Breakthrough Artist, Mr. Will Young.
Some said he wouldn't do it, but tonight the man who sold over 3 million singles has scooped the award for the British Breakthrough Artist of the Year.
I would say the highlight has been getting the Brit. I was very, very, very pleased. I got quite emotional, actually. Because it was almost exactly a year since winning the show, and I sort of felt like the hard work had paid off.
Well, I've got one more thing to say. Thank you very much to you guys for voting.
I can honestly say Will has not changed one little bit.
I probably think I'm funnier, but I don't think I am.
Will is just as wonderfully eccentric as he was during Pop Idol, and God bless him for that. I think that's part of the appeal with Will. His voice is better than ever, and he's got great songwriters, and I know he finds sometimes the management thing around him, and I think he finds it all difficult. He just wants to sing.
I think there are days when I think, oh God, why the hell do I do this job? But, you know, I think that's just that. I quite like those days because, you know, everyone has them in any job. And so it's kind of like makes it seem more real. If it was always like, wow, this is amazing the whole time, then I think it would be a bit surreal. Singing makes me very happy, but if it didn't, then I'd just stop doing the job.
Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. Come on, baby, light my fire.
Okay. Distinctly average, I'm afraid.
Could you elaborate a bit more, please?
I just thought it was totally normal. In the context of this show, I honestly didn't think it was good enough.
I think I behaved, looking back, childishly with Will. I really was sorry about the way I spoke about him, because it wasn't his fault that he won the competition, but I preferred the other guy.
You've just given it projected insults, and it has been terrible to watch. I think this show, I think you have been better, and I think you have given opinions, and you've backed up your opinions, which is what the other three do, which is what I respect.
I would like in the future to work with him, but there's about as much chance of that happening as me flying to the moon tomorrow.
I don't think Will would enjoy the roller coaster ride all over again. I think, you know, I think in a way he's pleased it's over and he can really do what he wants to do, which is be a proper musician.
I think I'll always be singing now, and that's what I wanted to do, and hopefully people will still be buying my music and enjoying my music, but if they're not, then I'll still be performing somewhere. I'll be in Bournemouth. The Will Young Show. Do you remember this, Pop Idol? Morning! Make it evergreen. An old classic from the 80s. Anything is possible.
And another one.
And no sunshine when she's gone.
There's no doubt that Pop Idol was brilliant for everyone concerned.
I was expecting to go back to my day job, which I still do, but I've also been presenting, so it's been a really good year.
Pop Idol has created a monster. It was one of those things, I think, when it was such a big hit here and we heard it was going to the States, we kind of knew that it was going to be a big hit out there.
And they didn't ask us to host it, but we're not bitter at all. We wish Simon all the best. Yeah, right.
I'm very well known in America. I would use the word notorious. And, you know, this show at times gets, you know, 40 million people watching it. That's a lot of people. So 40 million people suddenly know your name and know all about you. And the weird thing is, not so much when you're in Los Angeles, it's when you go to a tiny part of America which you'd never been before, and you go and buy a book, say, in a shopping mall, and 100 people come running up to you. That's when you realise that you've become so well known in a foreign country.
I do remember having a most bizarre conversation with the Queen of England about Pop Idol. You know, she had watched it, she knew what I did, and I remember talking to my friend, it was at some drinks party at Buckingham Palace, and I remember just coming out going, that is the most surreal conversation I'm sure I will ever have.
It was so massive in the end, everybody had their own opinions on their own winner and their own favourite and stuff, and because we hosted it, they wanted to tell us.
Yeah, which is, and everybody, I mean our own families, we'd go back to Newcastle to have a weekend off, and our own families were exactly the same. What's this person like? What's that person like? Is Simon Cowell really that nasty?
If I weren't there for you on those lonely nights, I'm so sorry. I'm so happy that you're mine.
Please.
Thomas, yeah, Thomas. Thomas. I'm going to say that is possibly the worst audition I have ever heard. Ever.
Okay.
What do you do for a living?
I'm more an actor than a singer, to be honest.
I really haven't held back too much, and I haven't said it. I haven't done things to be, you know, gratuitously rude, but I do try and say, you know, what's on my mind, and it doesn't always go down too well.
Everybody's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to.
Thank you. Randy.
I don't think that you're a solo singer at all. I think you're
Sorry?
I don't feel that you're a solo singer. I don't feel that you have a solo singer's voice.
I'm quite sure I sing a whole lot better than you do. And for you to tell me I need lessons...
Tamika. Enough.
I'm hurt and I'm angry.
Tamika, go to an audition where they lie to you. Thank you very much indeed.
Oh, no, I'm not about to go to an audition where they lie to me.
Yeah, we're telling you the truth and you don't want to hear it.
Go there. Thank you very much.
That British judge that's on the end, he's an ass and he can kiss mine.
Let's not kid ourselves. There are normally two, if you're lucky, three people who have a stab at having a half-decent or decent career out of this. The rest, in my opinion, make up the numbers. They make up the top 10. If we ever get a top 10 full of Will and Gareth, hallelujah, I don't ever think we will.
I enjoyed the Mickey taking of Simon and Pete, you know, week on week and dressing up as them.
Swear at me, would you, cowl kid? Eh? You big bodybuilding punts.
Good woman, I give you 2 out of 10.
We just thought we're just going to have a go at them and get them back, really. And I enjoyed those moments.
I know what you're thinking. Is this hairdryer plugged in? Eh? What do you ask yourself? Am I feeling lucky? Lucky, lucky, lucky.
Are you looking at me? I don't see anybody else here. Are you looking at me?
Right.
Peter, lovely to see you. Lovely outfit, blows me away.
Thanks, kid, thanks. Oh, by the way, thanks for the lip gloss.
No problem.
Ready to go and give the kid some hell?
Let me at him.
Well, 1 year on, it looks like Pop Idol has been more than kind to its finalists, not to mention Simon Cowell. We are now, without doubt, a British television phenomenon. And in the last 12 months, we've more than kept British single sales up here in the UK. And of course, Will, Gareth and Darius are more than household names. Would they ever have been signed without Pop Idol behind them? It's doubtful. So I like to think that we've served our purpose, which wraps up nicely Pop Idol 1. Can we do it all over again? You decide.
Coming up next here on ITV2, can Steve Martin and Goldie Hawn make a fresh start of it in New York? Find out with our big Saturday night movie, The Out of Towners, after the break.